On this episode of Miami Mic'd Up, we are joined by new addition, PJ Tucker. PJ, thanks for taking the time to join us today.
For sure. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. First question for you. What is something recently off the court that has brought you joy?
Ooh, this is so old of me, but my son, he got all A's, man. I couldn't believe it because he's been such a bad student. But we moved here. It must be Miami. I don't know what it is, but
yeah, that Miami school system.
Yeah, man, and he's doing really good in school. I'm like, I don't know, but I'll take it. So that brought me a lot of joy to see him happy and doing well in school.
That's awesome. I'm happy to hear it. What grade is he in? How old is he?
He is in the fourth grade. He's nine. He's hilarious. But I'm telling you. I guess when you know you're 36, it's like I got joy out of my son getting good grades finally. It was classic. And he's on the patrol, so he's like, I'm running late. I gotta go. Like, I'm gonna be late.
He's on top of his stuff. Yeah, that's awesome.
Like, helps kids like cross the street stuff before.
Like, yeah, like the safety patrol.
Yeah, safety patrol. So I gotta get there. Like, I gotta get up at like 6 a.m.
Oh, that's awesome though.
She's like, Dad, come on, I'm late. I'm like, he's doing good in school, so I can't complain.
That's huge. Yeah, I mean, having that experience and seeing him thriving now, even if it's just moving down here, getting up at 6 a.m. will be worth it.
Yeah, it is. It is. So that's my joy.
That's awesome. That's awesome. I'm glad to hear you guys have a close relationship like that.
Yeah.
Well, and coming from a guy who is known as like the tough guy,
right,
it's fun to hear that side of you right now. And as the tough guy coming down here, right, it feels like this Heat culture is a match made in heaven. I mean, you mentioned after that first practice how intense everything was. How much are you enjoying being in an environment like this?
It's just like tone set on tone, right? It's just like when you're like that and then it's already like that, it's just, you know, it's kind of like the same paint. You're just painting the same color, you know? And it's been a really easy transition. It's been fun. And I've been enjoying it every day. It's been good. So I'm excited about the season.
Yeah, I mean, obviously we're excited to have you down here. And particularly because last year you were part of a team that eliminated the Miami Heat in the Milwaukee Bucks. It was your first championship. I do want to hear, I know, you know, Heat fans are not exactly excited about the Bucks having won, but could you talk about just how special it was to be a part of that journey at this point in your career?
It was pretty special. It was. I tell people all the time, it wasn't like that. Like when I first got there, like we didn't. It was like everybody else. It's like you kind of, you know, talk. Everybody talks about it, right? Especially early in the season, everybody's like, "Yeah, we're for championship, man." Blah blah blah. All right, 6, 7, 8, maybe 8 teams that are really truly like, "All right, we got a shot." You know, we try to stay healthy, we do this, right, do that. But when I got there, it was, you know, it was tough. Like, it wasn't pretty. It wasn't, you know, we were still chipping away at it, trying to figure it out. We weren't winning every game. Like, it wasn't like, oh, we're going to win a championship right now.
Right.
You know, it was a goal, but it still had to be, you know, a lot of things had to happen. And throughout the course of that time and getting to the playoffs and each round presented different challenges. Literally each round was like totally different. And
yeah, totally different matchups.
Yeah,
too.
Matchups, the, you know, the stuff they had with Miami the season before.
Right.
So that kind of still lingered and people talked about that.
Yeah.
And then Brooklyn, obviously, that's a whole nother beast. And then Atlanta was so different because the Brooklyn was so high. And then you kind of come down off of that like, wait, it's not over.
Right.
It's like, it's not over. It's like, no, you still got two more series to win it all. So,
yeah.
And then dealing with that. And then the Suns, totally different too. So it was like literally like 4 different seasons, seriously, it felt like. So, but it was fun. It was definitely a process and was something I'll remember forever, but it was definitely one of those things.
Well, so you bring those things up about adjusting from series to series and all the things that you learned throughout that. So what do you believe you learned on that title run with Milwaukee that you can bring here to Miami and maybe even particularly in what will probably be a third round of that matchup, right? You had the Bucks in the Heat a couple years ago. You had it last year, and now you'll probably see it again in a playoff run.
Yeah. Honestly, it's just that, like, perseverance, you know, doing the things that you got to do now to prepare yourself to be ready to be able to go that far. Like, you can – like, people talk about being in June right now, but it's so far. You got to go through so much as a team. You have to fall, get up, clean yourself up, fight more. Like, it's – you're going to go through so many ups and downs up until then. So, almost don't even like looking at that part of it yet because the small stages are the stuff you're building yourself to become. You're going to need all those steps to be able to get to the top of the ladder. So And I love the steps. Like the step, you got to fall in love with the steps. Like you got to fall in love with the camp and doing all the craziness and, you know, being mad. Oh, we're all mad because we're working so hard. We're like, it's too early to see. Like you got to go through all those emotions and steps, and then that builds up to get to, you know, the end. So you can't think about that. You got to think about these steps and getting through them all throughout the season and preparing everybody.
Well, and those steps are the things that this organization constantly is talking about how much they love. So it's wonderful to see a player like you step right in and seemingly fit in perfectly to that culture. But I do want to take you sort of off the court for a second. I'm sure you get asked about this constantly, but your shoe game is unbelievable. And I was looking at YouTube videos last night of old interviews with you talking about your kicks. Where are you at right now in the collection? Where's the number? If I set the over under at 2,000 pairs of shoes, would it be over?
Well, I was at 5,000 in 2014. So
good God.
It was over five. We stopped counting at five. It was just some more left.
Counting at five.
And then, I mean, it's gotten crazier. I mean, it's like that was like the regular, and then now it's just like
so. The passion for it, the passion for shoes. Where did it come from?
It like always coincided with playing basketball, right?
Right.
I played basketball my whole life. I've never wanted to do anything else other than be a basketball player. I'm living my dream. Like it's
because
all that stuff was like I was like 6 years old hunting shoes. Like I wanted shoes to play in, right? Mm. Like I'm from North Carolina. Michael Jordan is. Michael Jordan.
He's like, Michael Jordan, right?
Like, you know, it's like the thing, right?
Yeah.
Like waking up at 5 o'clock in the morning in line, like it was the thing. And it was not just to get them and to like put them up and keep them and show them off. Like it's like get them and they're straight to the court. Like I'm getting on the court and I'm Mike right now. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Awesome.
Like that was what it was all about. It was like and people don't realize like the advertising, like it was such a thing. Like it wasn't just like collecting the shoes. It was like, it was like a movement.
You're going to be Michael Jordan.
Right. It was like a movement from all his commercials.
Be like Mike.
Be like Mike. Like, yeah, people like, I don't know. Like, if you're not my age, maybe you just don't understand. But it was really what it was.
It's remarkable. And so now to be at the point where you're at in that, where everybody's always coming to you for your probably advice or anything like that, you've also taken fashion and run with it in a big way as well. I saw you were at the Met Gala. Right.
Yeah.
What was that like? What was it like being at the Met Gala?
It was like being in a championship. Like that's like the championship of fashion.
Yeah,
it was
it
like you like rub elbows with the biggest people in fashion and just the conversations, the people you meet like that. Just that experience alone is like it's priceless. It's like you'll never get that group of people together for anything other than something like the Met Gala. So
for real,
he was just taking advantage of that and really having fun and enjoying it, and I had a great time.
Were there any sort of any celebrity run-ins that particularly stood out to you, or was this more about sort of hobnobbing and talking to the fashion people?
No. Like I met Tracee Ellis Ross. I was like,
oh my God. That's it.
I don't know if you
I can check
Friends
out. No, of course,
know,
man. That's
that
amazing.
Was like,
you're just standing there, just like freaking out the entire time.
Okay.
Did you guys have a conversation?
Yeah, she's really cool. She was cool. Whoopi Goldberg was really cool. She knew who I was. That was cool.
Oh, really? That's sick.
Yeah, it's like craziness. Like Jennifer Hudson. I was like, what? Like these people? Like what?
Does that ever? Does the fame of basketball ever surprise you? Like because you guys really become such household names, and then particularly someone like you that's taken your brand and run with it in a different way. Do you ever get like almost overwhelmed by, holy cow, look at where basketball has brought me?
For sure. All the time. From doing the Dolce fashion show this year to Met Gala, all that stuff. It's like I'm so far away from basketball and to still be in that is like crazy. It never gets old. And you don't realize how many people are basketball fans, too, until you get in those moments. And they're like, game six, you did this. you were going to give up. And you kept fighting. And they're like, you're looking at them like, what? Like, you seen that? Like,
right.
It's crazy.
It's amazing.
Yeah,
well,
it is.
I guess it's the same way that we watch their TV shows or movies. It's all entertainment at the end of the day.
Entertainment.
So with that being said, we will wrap up here. I don't want to keep you too long.
All good.
Going into this season, obviously, you're coming off of a championship. The Miami Heat are not. What do you have to do to repeat? So what do you believe this team has to do to get themselves back to the NBA Finals like they were just a couple seasons ago?
We got
to
go through the steps. Those same steps I was talking about, we got to go through all of them. We're going to have to stay healthy, and that's going to be a big, big, big thing because I think whoever stays healthy this year is who's going to win it or who's going to be there at the end. that I think people kind of forget that part of it.
Absolutely.
You got to be healthy. If your guys aren't out there, you don't got a chance, and you never know what's going to happen. So just give yourself a chance and being healthy. But all the steps, when I look at our team and our makeup, if we can be as good as I think we're going to be defensively, I think we'll be able to score enough points with the shooters and playmakers that we have on our team. But more than that, it's the attitude of our team, right? It's the dog mentality that I always talk about. We got so many guys with it, and even guys that people don't realize have it because they're not like me. They're not loud and rah-rah, right. But they definitely are dogs in a whole nother way. That's going to be a key because the leadership is there. The tools are there. It's just putting it together.
Well, we're certainly looking forward to watching it. PJ Tucker, thank you so much for joining us on this episode of Miami Mic'd Up.
Appreciate it.